In this video, I will show you how you can train your own custom model using Replicate. I'll be using Flux LoRA to train the model. I used almost 30 images as the dataset for training. If you are wondering how to train your own custom model that generates images exactly like how you look, maintaining the facial structure and everything, so this video is for you. I'll be showing all the steps required to train your own model, and it's very simple. So let's get into it. First, I gathered 30 images. These are a mix of portraits, close-ups, and a few wide shots. So the training data should cover different angles, different facial expression, different dresses, and different lighting. Training data should have different type of informations to generate different looks. If you are going to use any specific set of images where you are wearing only the same clothes and the same lighting, then your training data will be trained on that same lighting and same clothes. It will be hard for you to generate your images in different look, different ambience, different location. Please keep that in mind. You have to have variety in your training data. Don't use too much close-up. You can see these images. These are my training data. You can see different angles, different clothes, some outdoor images, some indoor images, studio lighting. So it have a variety. So the goal was to give the AI enough examples to understand the pattern, the lighting, the color and the composition. Then go to Replicate. First you have to log in, go to this links, Flux Def LoRA Trainer. I have added the link in the description. Just scroll down, you can see the destination. So you have to select a model. If you are using it for the first time, you have to create your new model. Click on create new model. I'm using Aria, and then you have to select public. I'm keeping it public. Then just scroll down. You can see the input images. You have to upload all the images, but you have to zip all the files before uploading. So go to the finder and make a zip file containing all the images, and then click on this upload button and locate your zip file and click upload. So you can see that your zip file is added. Now the trigger word. So this is the most important thing to call your trained model whenever you are going to generate any images. So trigger word is just like a name given to your model. In the prompt, whenever you type this trigger word, your model will be called and your model will be used to generate the images. For this, I am using Aria as the trigger word. I will show you everything by the end of the video. Scroll down and make sure auto caption is selected, because we are not captioning any images. So it will automatically add captions to every images that you have uploaded, and it will be used for the training. Make sure auto caption is selected. Scroll down, you can see steps and LoRA rank. I have trained multiple models and I feel 2000 is the best starting point. You can go higher, cost will increase. And for LoRA rank, keep it 16 or any value between 16 to 23. Whenever you increase this value, your cost and timing for training model will increase also. And then scroll down, HF repo ID. This is the Hugging Face repo ID. Now you have to go to Hugging Face to create your repo, means repository. Hugging Face is basically a GitHub for all AI models. So once you log into your Hugging Face, click on your icon and you can see this drop down. Click on new model. This page will open. Give a name for this model. I am using Aria, and then you don't have to add anything in the license. And remember to select public, because we are going to use Replicate and we will be generating images through Replicate. So if you keep it in private, the Replicate will not able to use the model that is being stored in this repo in Hugging Face. So remember to keep it in public and scroll down and click on create model. That's it. Your repository is created with the name Aria. You can see a square box to copy the repo ID. Click on this box, your repo ID will be copied, and go back to Replicate. And in the HF repo ID field, just simply paste it. Just after that, you can see Hugging Face token. You have to create a token from Hugging Face and paste it here. So let's go back to Hugging Face. Click on your icon. You can see access token. Click on access token. Click on create new token. This page will open with lot of option. Don't panic. First add a token name. I'm using Replicate LoRA Aria as the token name. You can use anything. And remember to tick everything, all the options have to be ticked. Okay, and click on create token. Just copy it and click done and go back to Replicate and paste your token in the Hugging Face token field. And that's it, the main work is all done. And just scroll down and you can see create training and click on create training. If you have done everything properly, your training will start. You can see extracting 53 files and it's creating checkpoints. I'm speeding up the process. It took me almost 40 to 50 minutes for the training to complete. So once your training is done, you can see your training was successful. You can now run the model. Now you have to go to Flux Dev LoRA to use your model. So I'll add this link also in the description. Once you open this link, you will see a castle image. Before generating the images, you have to do one important step to use the model. You have to copy the Hugging Face repo ID and paste it in the Hugging Face LoRA field. Just paste that and that's it. And start writing your prompt. In the prompt section, you have to add the token keyword, which was Aria, to call your own trained model. So I'm using Aria wearing a sunglass on a mountain and looks fashionable like a male fashion model. And you can set the aspect ratio. I have kept it 4:5. You have to keep playing with the seed value. Once you get good images of you on a certain seed value, remember that seed value and keep using that seed value to generate different images. In few seed values, your face will not look exactly like you, but in certain seed value, your face will exactly look like you. So remember those seed values and keep using those seed values to generate different images of you. I'm keeping all the values like prompt strength as default 0.8 and interference, I generally keep it between 28 to 31, 32. Works best. Once everything is done, click on run and it will start generating your images. I'm using 1111 as the seed value and you can see it have generated an image of me wearing a sunglass in the mountain and it looks good. Let's generate a prompt using ChatGPT. Told ChatGPT that Aria is my token keyword, so it have added the Aria in the prompt itself. See, you can see Aria. Copy the prompt and it have generated this black and white image of me. I have generated multiple images with different prompts and it have generated this me smiling, and this was another prompt, ultra detailed high resolution studio portrait of Aria smiling outdoor in park, a man, and then my token word Aria. And if you have added the token in a capital letter, you have to use the capital letter only. You cannot use lowercase if you have used uppercase as the token word. Remember that. And these are few images that I've generated. I really like these images. So I have trained this LoRA model with my face. You can use anything. Like it can be a physical product, maybe a sunglass or a physical mug. Suppose you are owning a brand, you have a physical product, maybe a sunglass. You can do the shoot with your iPhone camera, it works best, or with a DSLR. But remember to capture the images in a high resolution format and create a training data set. Minimum of 15 images is required to get a good training model. Then train the model and start generating the images of your product for your ad campaigns, and the images that you will be generating will have the exact look of your product. In other AI image generating tools, if you add a reference image as your product is replicated, it doesn't look exactly like your product. So this training is very important to have a very consistent images of your product or of yourself. You can approach different brands and can have some deal with them that you will be providing this certain amount of images every week or every month, and they can use those images for social media. So the brands will not require photographers, studio hiring, models and everything, and their cost for production will be reduced by a lot, and you will get a consistent amount of work from them. So you can create a nexus of different type of works and projects revolving around this. These things are the new future. You have to keep adapting to all these things, new techs and new ways of working for real life commercial products, real life commercial works. So these are valuable information. Hope you like this video. And please don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll be back with a new video soon. Bye-bye.